Good day, my fair Waymakers. Today we are celebrating the Festival of the Arts, and we are putting on a play for you. So, let me open up my scroll. Greetings, I am Horatia.
Oh, Mr. Mustache, what are you doing out here?
Oh, no, thank you. I'm okay. You're one of the actors. You need to get back there and get dressed.
Where's Mr. Mustache? We need him here. He's got to get ready.
It's okay. Shortly, our play will be on. Mr. Mustache. Mustache, quit messing around back there. Let me get dressed. Makers, today for our Fast Five, we have five facts about culture and art. So, for the Festival of the Arts, we are going to talk about that. Number one, culture is the arts. So, whatever you're going to, musically, or ballet, or art pieces, that is culture. Number two, culture is our attitudes, how we act towards one another or socially interact with each other as a group of people. That is a culture. Number three, art is anywhere from music to poetry to dance to art pieces. It's everything. Number four, art is an arrangement or to arrange. Fun fact. And last but not least, number five, creativity, social development, and self-worth are often found through our art.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, righteousness, they will be filled.
Okay, so now it's time for our logo motion time. So stand up and get your hands ready because we're going to learn our key verse today, which is Genesis 1:27. It says, "So God created man in his own image, in the image of God. He created him, male and female, he created them." Genesis 1:27. So now let's try the motions. So God, this is God, created man in his own image, in the image of God. Okay, that's the first part. Second part. He created him. This is male. Male. And this is female. And female, he created them. Okay, now I'm going to do a little bit faster. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. Genesis 1:27. One last time. Here we go. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. Genesis 1:27. That's a tough one, but I think you guys can figure it out. Greetings, I am Horatia, your storyteller for today's play. Today's play is a tale to prepend, or to think of and consider, the Sermon on the Mount from our dear Sovereign Lord and Savior, the Almighty Jesus Christ. Look upon our mute comedians as they impaint this posy. Let's begin. To be or not to be, blessed because you are poor in the spirit, for yours is the kingdom of heaven. To be or not to be, blessed because you mourn, for you shall be comforted. To be or not to be, blessed because you are meek, for you shall inherit the earth. To be or not to be, blessed because you hunger and thirst for righteousness, for you shall be satisfied. To be or not to be, blessed because you are merciful, for you shall receive mercy. To be or not to be, blessed because you are pure in heart, for you shall see God. To be or not to be, blessed because you are the peacemakers, for you shall be called sons of God. To be or not to be, blessed because you are persecuted for your righteous sake, for yours is the kingdom of heaven. This concludes our story, dear friends. Now it's your choice to be or not to be. Hi, Waymakers. For today's life skill, we will be learning about poetry. So that doesn't really sound like your average life skill, but it is, because the way that we deal with our emotions or express our feelings is very valuable in life. So, for example, if you watch America's Got Talent, the winner of this year was Brandon Leake, who is a high school teacher. He teaches poetry or spoken word to his students so that they can properly express their emotions and express themselves. So, that is pretty cool. We have two different types of poem that we can use today that are easier forms of writing poems for us to get started. So our first way is by the acrostic, which is kind of like an acronym. So you pick a word that you want to use, and then each letter is the beginning of a word that describes that word as a whole. Second is a rhyming poem. So if you like to rhyme, even in songs, a lot of songs, it rhymes. It helps us to remember things. So let's try it. So let's pick a word. Club. Okay. So C-L-U-B. So what could go with C? Well, I know for our club, we're Christian. So I'm going to write Christian. Okay, and we teach life skills. We are unified, or we have unity in our group, so we're all like-minded. Kind of a big word. And for B, we read out of our Bible. So for our acrostic poem today, for club, our club, we're Christian, we teach life skills, we're unified, or we have unity, and we read out of the Bible. So that's our first example. Second is a rhyming poem. Okay, now this is a poem that I found. It's called God the Father, and it's a Christian version of Jack Sprat, if anybody's ever read that poem. So, I'm going to start writing it and see if you can figure out where it rhymes. God the Father could have no sin. Okay, that's the first line. His son became sin to pay, and so between them both, comma, U-C, comma, they made the way. Okay, now, can you see where it rhymes in this poem? God the Father could have no sin. His son became sin to pay, and so between them both, you see, they made the way. So what are the rhyming words in that one? I think pay and way are the rhyming words. Now you can have any sort of rhythm that you want for your poem, but as long as it rhymes, at least every other line, see, I did a rhyme, then you can have a rhyming poem. So there's some simple, easy ways to write poems. To today we learned about the Beatitudes from our fun theatrical play that we did. But I want to go back and read them really quickly, and then we'll discuss how they pertain to art. So, in Matthew chapter 5, Jesus goes up on the mount to preach a sermon to the people of Israel. It says, "Now, when he saw the crowds, he went up on the mountainside and sat down. His disciples came to him, and he began to teach them, saying, 'Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me. Rejoice and be glad, because great is your reward in heaven. For in the same way, they persecuted the prophets who were before you." The Beatitudes are a form of poetry, and that is why we were learning about poetry today. However, it's also a form of art, because God made us in His image, and we need to be able to preserve His masterpiece with our attitudes. How we act as Christians is the image that we are portraying to others who are watching us and looking at us and investigating us. They want to see Christ in us. So, if we are made in God's image, we need to preserve that and keep those Beatitudes in our character. And that is a hard thing to do, because our culture says everything the opposite. We are called to be peacemakers, but oftentimes we fight. We are called to be meek, but oftentimes we're haughty and we try to be know-it-all. All of these Beatitudes are what God wants us to be as His people, and we will be blessed and rewarded for it in heaven. So thank you for joining us today, and I hope that you learned a lot about culture and art.